Good afternoon, dear students. Deepali ma'am here. Today I am starting with science topic lesson 1, that is nutrition and living organism, that is plants. First of all, what are nutrients? Nutrients are the components of food which are necessary for our body. For example, vitamins, proteins, carbohydrates, fats and all, which you have studied in your previous class. Then comes the nutrition. Definition of nutrition: the process of obtaining food by an organism and use it as energy is called as nutrition. Means we are eating the food and using it as energy in our daily routine, it is called nutrition. Nutrition is of two types: autotrophic mode of nutrition and heterotrophic mode of nutrition. Auto means self. Plants are only the living organism on this earth which prepare their own food by the process of photosynthesis. This equation you have already studied in the previous class. Carbon dioxide, water in the presence of sunlight and chlorophyll prepare their own food, carbohydrates, and the waste product is the oxygen. So these are the raw materials very essential for the plants. Heterotrophic mode of nutrition means the living organism which depend on other plants for their on other living organism for their food, as we are also taking the heterotrophic mode of nutrition. Now comes the raw materials which are essential in the process of photosynthesis. First of all, water and minerals. Where are they present? Location is soil. Water we give in the soil, or either minerals are there in the soil. So they are absorbed by the roots, and then the roots send it to the leaves with the help of vessels. Vessels are xylem and phloem, which you will study in your further chapters. Second raw material is carbon dioxide. Carbon dioxide, it is taken by stomata, which is the nose of the plant. Stomata is guarded by the guard cells. Third raw material is sunlight taken from the sun, chlorophyll, which is the green pigment already present in the plants. Then the product obtained. Product obtained is carbohydrates, carbon, hydrogen and oxygen. Then comes one more very essential raw material for photosynthesis, that is nitrogen gas. Nitrogen gas cannot be taken directly by the plants, so that's why it is taken by the soil, and with the help of bacteria it is converted into usable form and sent to the leaves for the process of photosynthesis. Now some plants who are not green in color, but still they do the process of photosynthesis. What is the reason behind it? Listen carefully. Some plants have leaves which are not green in color. Such leaves contain chlorophyll, but it is masked due to the presence of other colorful pigments. Means they have green pigment, but on that there is mask of other colorful pigments. The presence of this additional pigments such as red, purple is there, but still they can perform the process of photosynthesis. So the question is, if the plants are not green in color, still they perform the process of photosynthesis? This is the answer. They are masked by the colorful pigments, but still they are doing the process of photosynthesis. Then comes other modes of nutrition. Means there are many more modes of nutrition in plants. Heterotrophic. Who does the heterotrophic? Means plants which cannot prepare their own food. Very common example is cuscuta. Some plants depend on other plants for their food, that is heterotrophic nutrition. Cuscuta, it is yellowish thread like structure. It is without leaves and it grows on other plants. This is the characteristic of cuscuta. I repeat, it is does not contain leaves and it grows on other plants. Cuscuta is a type of parasite. It takes in nutrition from other living organism and it also causes harm to other organism. The plant on which it grows is called as host. Means it is growing on another plant and it is also taking the nutrition, as well as it is giving harm to that host also. So this is the characteristic of cuscuta. Yellowish thread structure, it is a parasite, it is harming the host, it is not having its own leaves, but it is growing on another plant. Another type of plant is insectivorous plants. Insectivorous plants are which feed on the insects for their nitrogen requirements. Means they cannot change the nitrogen gas into the usable form, so they feed on other insects for the use of nitrogen. Very common example is the pitcher plant. Pitcher plant is an insect eating plant. it is a modified pitcher with a lid, means it has a cover on it. It opens its lid, the insect goes inside and it takes the juices from that, which mostly contain nitrogen. So such type of plants are called as insectivorous plants. Thank you children, we will continue afterwards with another topic.